20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. Having never read the book by Jules Verne, or seen any of the many adaptations for screen, and only vaguely aware of the character of Captain Nemo, I was excited to watch Disney's 1954 version. And whilst I'm glad I now have done, I don't think I'll be returning to it again. Acutely aware of my 2021 lens, I really tried to see this for what it was, a rip-roaring under-the-sea yarn. But with a 2-hour, 15-minute runtime, we neither ripped nor did we roar. Saying this, there is still plenty to enjoy. Every scene that takes place underwater is magical. Shot in the Bahamas, the actors don old-fashioned sea diving suits and go about their life beneath the waves. The first thing the audience sees is a funeral taking place, with a crucifix made of coral, and the slow movements of the people allowing you to take the whole scene in. I'd never seen anything like it, even today. The famous stormy fight with the giant squid looks great. It's exciting and probably still quite scary to younger audiences. And James Mason as Captain Nemo, despite not being of Indian origins as the novel's sequel, which still came out 78 years before the film, divulges, his performance is as fascinating as his character. Not nearly as fascinating is the performing sea lion who is fed whiskey and cigars throughout, and the island of cannibals who are scared away by electricity. I understand it was made in 1954, and I understand things were different back then. Many old films and shows these days rightly have a disclaimer at the beginning, warning of offensive and dated depictions. We are also rightly still able to watch them, because to pretend it never happened is worse. Interestingly, 20,000 Leagues has no such disclaimer, despite having offensive depictions, which asks the question, is this therefore still deemed as an acceptable portrayal within film? Some modern productions that are clearly influenced by this film and its contemporaries still answer yes, but I would like to ask why. With no discernible main character and a rather episodic feel, the film meanders along at a slow pace, not ever really allowing me to root for anyone, but neither does it really dive into any of the morals or dilemmas presented by the characters and their actions. Kirk Douglas is annoying. The story has some great elements. Nemo is an iconic anti-hero, and you can still see the influence today that this story and film has had on its genre. It would relish a remake that shows the difficult history alluded to in the novels, a conversation we should all be having. I feel the Muppets could have a good stab at it, but to do it justice, it needs thought, care, and no cigar-fed sea lions.